All Volvo wheel loaders have automatic gear shifting with 4 forward gears and 4 reverse gears. When the gear shift selector is in the 4th position, the machine will normally shift automatically from gears from 2 to 4. In the 3rd position, the machine is still automatic, but only uses 2nd and 3rd gears. In the 2nd position, the machine will remain in 2nd gear. When traveling greater distances, the 4th position is a good choice. For you, the operator, it's easy, regardless which position the shift selector is in. Just choose between forward and reverse. Downshifting to first gear can be done in several ways. The kickdown button is located on the electric servo control. If you prefer CDC lever steering, there's even a kickdown button on the CDC console. You can also select automatic downshifting to first gear using the full automatic power shift located on the A-post. First gear is primarily used when pushing logs with the push bar. The automatic shifting program ensures that all shifts are made at just the right time for optimal comfort and fuel economy. Volvo High-Lifts are equipped with a mode selector and automatic power shift, or APS, with 4 different shifting programs. They control when the gear change occurs, taking into consideration the machine's engine RPM and speed. Thanks to the mode selector, you have an excellent opportunity to choose a gear shifting program that matches your specific operating technique and working conditions. But keep in mind that various shifting programs only move the shifting points. The machine will never be any stronger or faster in one mode or the other. In the auto position, the machine's computer selects the shifting program according to the current operating condition in order to achieve the best comfort and economy. When selected, an A is shown in the display. Normally, the auto position is the best all-round choice for optimal fuel economy and highest productivity in all kinds of work. In certain working conditions, you may feel that the machine is shifting too early, too late, or too often when in auto mode. You can then choose any of the other modes. Mode L means the machine shifts at a low engine RPM or a low traveling speed. When selected, an L is shown in the display. When the traveling speed or engine RPM are within the white area, no shifting will occur. But as soon as the speed and engine RPM enter the blue area, shifting will begin. In M mode, the machine shifts at a slightly higher engine RPM or traveling speed. In H mode, the range where no shifting occurs will be even larger. Here, the machine will only shift at higher engine RPMs and traveling speeds. When activated, an H is shown in the display. The machine is equipped with lockup, and you may activate it to reduce fuel consumption. When lockup is activated, a symbol will be shown in the display. Always perform transport with the carry position activated for maximum stability and comfort. The load structure is set to the carry position when you activate the system. In the carry position, the boom suspension is active. Volvo's boom suspension system effectively absorbs shocks and reduces the bouncing and rocking that often occurs when operating over rough ground. It also includes in-position damping for tilt function forward, backward, and for lifts. This means that the hydraulic pressure is reduced before the attachment reaches its end position. The result is better comfort and productivity in all types of work. The system has 2 modes, gear dependent and speed dependent. The boom suspension system will only work when the carry position is activated. When the switch is in the middle position, the boom suspension system is in gear-dependent mode. In this position, the boom suspension is active in all gears except first gear. Volvo recommends to use the gear-dependent mode in high-lift applications. When filling the grapple, the boom is rigid. However, as soon as you reverse the machine and activate the carry position, the boom suspension is once again engaged. Suspension does not disengage until you shift down to first gear or until the next time you move the tilt. In speed-dependent mode, the boom suspension is activated once the machine exceeds a certain speed. However, this setting is not optimal for high-lift applications. Consult your operator's manual for more information. The machine is equipped with a diesel particulate filter that traps exhaust particles for a later regeneration process. When soot particles reach a certain level, you'll be alerted via the display. During the regeneration process, which takes about 30 to 40 minutes to convert the soot particles to non-toxic gas, you may continue to work. Don't activate the regeneration process if the machine is in a flammable environment, for example, under a tree or wooden roof. Postpone it until you can reach a safer area. During normal operation, the machine also uses AdBlue DEF to fulfill emission requirements. All Volvo wheel loaders have automatic gear shifting with 4 forward gears and 4 reverse gears. Volvo wheel loaders are equipped with a mode selector for different shifting programs. Use the gear-dependent mode on Volvo's optional boom suspension when operating your high lift.